Good morning, CSL Kelowna. It is so great to be with you this morning, all the way from Charlotte, North Carolina. Reverend Christy here. So I want to teach you a new song. I can just hear Barb and Neil singing this one, so let's learn it before they do. Here we go.
So good morning, everyone. We are Love and Light. Thank you, Christy Snow, and you're going to hear more of her as our morning goes on. So what I want to say, though, is Happy New Year. I am so, so happy that you're here to release the old and to welcome the new. I read a great ditty in the newspaper, and it was, "The bad news is time flies, and the good news is that you're the pilot." So welcome to 2022. As Mary Morrissey would say, it is a brand new baby year. And like babies, at this point, it is nothing but potential and possibilities. So think about that just for a second. You know, the future is beckoning us. It's new, it's shiny, it's all of that. And for sure, the future is the home to our hopes and our dreams. And the past, well, I don't need to tell anybody that 2021 had its challenges. And I don't know if you remember, but last year at this time, my guiding word that I encourage us all to come up with every year, my guiding word was lightheartedness. And, well, you know, I don't really know how that worked, but it was a great reminder to have that no matter what was going on, that I had had an intention to go through it with a light heart, which of course, sometimes I did and sometimes I didn't, being human at all. But for sure, it would just remind me to just check in. You know, am I approaching like whatever this thing that's happening with a light heart? And could I look at whatever was happening differently? So for me, it's not so much about the word itself. It's more about the prompt to be aware that it provided me. And so it was good. Do you remember your word from last year? And did you try to sort of come back to it as the months went by? You know, it's always just good to check in on these things. So for this year, I've decided that my word is surrender. And there's so much change in the air everywhere. And for sure, there is a lot of change happening here at our center as we look into the new year. Most of you know we've sold our Peace Center and we are allowing the newness of our next place to emerge. So we are starting also to move into succession planning for our center's next spiritual director. Now, not tomorrow, so don't start any rumors, but it is a really good time for us to start thinking about it and implanting our new ideas. You know, and we know as things reconfigure, in some ways, all of us and our center are going to be starting afresh. And my sense is that right now, there is a whole lot that I can't figure out from my human mind. And so my word is all about surrendering to that divine wisdom that I know is everywhere present, and to mix that with a little bit of trust and some faith and move bravely forward and embrace the new in 2022. And so with the help of our spiritual leadership, we've come up with what I think is the perfect theme for our center this upcoming year. And it is honoring our past and embracing the new in 2022. And so that just really resonated for me, and I hope that it does for you too. And no matter what, it all begins with you in 2022. So we will, of course, continue to sort of loosely follow our greater organization, CSL, their theme for 2022, which is Living Everyday Wonder, which is all about finding the wonder in the miracles of daily life, moment by moment, and to really encourage us to look at our world with curiosity and open minds and open hearts. And so before we move into our meditation ceremony to officially kick off the new year, I just want to make sure that you are up to date with some events that are coming up. So I am delighted and excited that we are offering an accredited Science of Mind class once again, a fantastic way to kick off the new year. And it is the foundations of the Science of Mind. And it's the perfect class, really, whether you're just learning some of the principles or you're remembering some of the very practical tools that'll be offered for creating balance and faith for our what has been our kind of topsy-turvy world. So it's 10 weeks and it starts this coming Tuesday at 6 o'clock. It's only 2 hours, so it's really easily workable into your schedule, and it's being offered at a very affordable price so that it's easily accessible for all. You can register on our website, and you know, I think with kind of at least here the latest restrictions, class is such a good place to connect and to learn. And so if you do one thing for yourself, this just might be it. I'm looking forward to going. So also, we were planning an in-person service on January the 9th, but due to the current mandates, we've decided to cancel that. But we will be here on Facebook Live full force, and we've got something new. So I invite you to come and check out the very first of our Community Sunday services. And lastly, I would love to invite you to our third and final community visioning session for now. So this is going to be next Sunday at 1 o'clock on Zoom. And visioning is a process designed to avail ourselves to Spirit's highest vision. And we're doing this for our community. It is actually a simple process with very profound results. Everyone is welcome, whether you've been to the previous sessions or not, and the link will be on our website. So that's all the news that's fit to print for now. And so onto our practice for this morning. So what's going to happen is I'm going to set the stage, and then we were going to have one of the best musicians and meditation leaders, Reverend Christy Snow, who you heard at the top of the service, all the way from South Carolina. She is going to lead us through an active experience of letting go and releasing our lesser kind of human foibles and replacing them with our intentions for good. And so you can use this time to release past patterns, hurts, resentments in a very safe and sacred space. It is the perfect way to let go of that which might be holding you back and weighing you down. And this release work is super powerful because what it really does, it creates a vacuum and room for newness. So again, after the release, we will plant seeds for our futures. And I would really love to invite you to fully participate. I know many of you like to multitask during our services, but maybe just for today, I could encourage you to just take this time to sit and be fully present with this opportunity. You know, and I know that sometimes doing a meditation online isn't the same as in person, but let's do this today really knowing that we are together in consciousness, which truly knows no time or space. And the truth is that mind is everywhere present in its wholeness, and so our collective mind of our planet is powerfully impacted by our group energy together, no matter where we might be physically. And so I'm going to set the stage again with two things. And the first is a reading, and it's from the Joyous Living Journal, written by Drs. Peter Weldres and Christian Sorensen. They're both CSL ministers. And then I will follow that up with a treatment. So the reading first. So behind all the fun and flash of New Year, there is a deep spiritual significance of this time. But did you know it's only in the last few hundred years that the Western culture has come to recognize January the 1st as the start of the new year? Up until 1752, the British Empire celebrated their new year on the 25th of March, which I just remember that was the anniversary of Ken's and my first date. Sidebar. But celebrate everyone did, and as have people through time, we participate in symbolically ending a chapter and then beginning the next. So there are varying New Year's customs, which, you know, you might think of them as superstitions. There's polar bear plunges, there's people throwing things out their windows, people burning effigies at midnight, which all seem to come from a parallel conviction of setting things right, cleaning up messes, making amends, and things like that. And so it's about completing the old and beginning the new year in the manner in which you would like it to unfold. And as you sweep out the old, it's important to fill the space with what you desire. Otherwise, the old will fill the void with whatever it's got left over. So apparently, in some Spanish-speaking cultures, one of the more popular New Year traditions involves buying new underwear in a certain color to determine what kind of experience you'll have in the upcoming year. Apparently, each color attracts a specific intention. I'm not going to say any more about that. Whatever tradition you're choosing, toasting with champagne, watching the fireworks, watching the ball drop in Times Square, people around the globe are recognizing the important transition from what was and welcoming what can be through their symbolic actions. So be conscious as to what you're calling into your new year. So with that as our overview, let us move into one of the most powerful tools this teaching offers, the technology of spiritual mind treatment or positive prayer. And then after this treatment, we'll be calling in Reverend Christy Snow. So I invite you in this moment to just get comfortable. Have your feet solidly on the floor and open yourself up by maybe uncrossing your arms and legs and let your eyes close. And as you do this, just become aware of the indwelling presence of God. Become still, open, and receptive, as together we recognize the collective oneness of which we are all a part of. And remembering within our hearts and minds that we are immersed in divine intelligence, in safety, and unconditional love. And so I know that there is one power and one presence. Spirit, mind, God, good is all there is. And I know that each of us are one in the one as the one. This time of year with the end of the old and the beginning of the new is prime for us to very consciously release what no longer serves and to create the space to welcome the inner qualities we want to be. We do this by remembering our beingness in spirit, and which allows us to go beyond the sometimes limited consciousness of the human mind. And so I surrender to being more spirit-guided and spirit-led. I release relying on my human ego and living out of my smaller personality and opinions. And I lean fully into the aspects of spirit, life, love, light, peace, power, beauty, and joy. And my greater knowing is that the one mind of all humanity, the collective thinking of the world, is amenable to change as more and more of humanity remembers who and whose they are. We are more love. We are more peace. We are more good. And so I affirm for each of us here today that this powerful time together makes a difference in our lives, and it makes a difference in our entire planet, the one mind throughout all humanity. And so I am so powerfully grateful to know that these words are true in mind and therefore in experience. So I release them with trust and with faith to the law of mind, which has already made them so. And so it is. And now, Reverend Christy Snow.
Surrender. I trust and know that as I surrender, I fall into the arms of love. Thank you. So in this moment, let us take time to fall into those arms of love. Let's surrender into, not outside of ourselves, but into that power and presence that resides within. Surrendering into that power and presence that knows how when we do not, that leads the way. I surrender into that. I give up in this moment any ideas of smallness, any limiting beliefs, patterns, or actions. I give up any ideas of separation. I am willing to release my good for my better. So at this time, I just take my own personal inventory and I decide for myself at this new start to this beautiful year, what am I ready to let go of? Perhaps a resentment, an idea of us and them. Or maybe it's another way that you have decided in your mind that you are separate from another. So ask yourself, what do I need to release in order to be and to do and to have all that I'm here to be and do and have, to do the things that ought to be done by me? What do I need to release so that I can be the vessel of love that I'm here to be in this life? What do I need to release so that I can live life freely in this material universe? What old way of thinking needs to be purged for me to be able to welcome love to the highest level? Ask these questions for yourself. What within me needs to change to welcome more respect, more harmony, more joy, more excitement, more enthusiasm, more passion for living? What within me needs to change? And say with me, I am willing. I am willing to change. Willing to forgive. Willing to grow. Willing to respond to life with love, kindness, and compassion. By first being willing to treat myself with love, kindness, and compassion, I let self-care be my absolute priority. Self-love and living life to the juicy fullest. So releasing anything seen or unseen, any blocks known or unknown that have stood between me and my highest, greatest good, I say I surrender, and that's what surrender means to me. Just a release of anything that could possibly dampen my spirit and darken my light. I release. As I surrender into that power and presence, that divine intelligence, by that infinite orchestrating power that resides within me as I surrender and fall into that. It is indeed love itself. And through that surrender, through that opening, through that, I am able to live with an open heart, an open mind, an open life, to be an open vessel. Thank you, God. I am opening more and more with each and every breath, with each and every intentional breath in this life. I'm opening in my heart is ready to receive. It is ready to be a beacon of light, an example of love, an example of what's possible through that love. I am opening to the greater truth within me, the bigger truth, that there are no limits, that there is no separation between me and the beloved presence that created me and all of its creation. I am open to the truth of my magnificent self. I am open to be and to do and to have and to shine and to love. Just as I say, I am opening. I know that each and every person joining today is also opening. For we are here by divine appointment, brought together to co-create this experience, to join in consciousness, to be open, to receive, and to be that light of love. Judgment and blame and guilt and places of unforgiveness, as you open and you release and you're ready to receive love, then you're ready to be the love. I am, you are, we are opening. Our hearts are ready to receive and to be that beacon. We are opening. We are opening. hearts are ready to receive. We are opening, we are opening. Our hearts are ready to receive. As open as your heart is open, as our hearts are open, and we are willing to be that light of love. Change happens. And together, through this open-hearted awareness, this conscious evolution, we create a world that works for everyone. We are the ones that we've been waiting for. The time is now, and it is up to us. But it all depends on our willingness to release, surrender, open, and to be led by love, to be that love. And it starts one heart at a time. Sing with me. I am opening. Maybe place your hand on your heart. I'm opening. My heart is ready to receive. I am opening. I am opening. My heart is ready. Once more, like a prayer. I am opening, opening. My heart is ready to receive. And as we become open, open to receive and to be free, free, free to love and free to share, the world continues to shine with our collective consciousness as we wrap our love around this globe. As we choose to know that our unity is expressing as a blanket of love wrapping around this entire globe. So as we continue to open and to be that light of love, we just go within with every breath and say, lead me. I'm willing. Lead me. Lead me, love. Lead me, love. Lead me on. When I'm weary, make me strong. Lead me, love. Help me to grow. Lead me, love. Lead me, love. Lead. weary. Make me strong. Lead me, love. Help me grow. Lead me, love. Lead me on. Lead me on. So as the music just continues for a moment, I'm going to give you just a few minutes to do your own personal inventory to make sure there's nothing else left within that needs to be released. What within me needs to change? What do I need to release? What do I need to embrace? So maybe just close your eyes and allow yourself to have just a moment to explore those questions. What within me needs to change? What do I need to release and to embrace to be all that I'm here to be and to contribute to the awakening, the awakening of love consciousness around this planet? And so it is, and so we let it be.
Thank you, Reverend Christy. What a fabulous way to start a new year. I'm always impressed with musicians because I don't have a lot of music talent myself, but I don't know that I've ever seen anybody play an instrument while they have another one under one arm and a guitar over the shoulder, and then she was switching. I'm just so impressed. Good morning. My name is Derek Hinchliffe. I am the treasurer of CSL Kelowna. Good morning and happy new year. And what a better way to start a new year than by committing to supporting our center. I just want to give a shout out to all the conscious givers. You are the backbone of our center. And I want to invite anybody else who is not a conscious giver to give that serious consideration, to make a commitment to yourself and to the center to support us financially throughout 2022. If you are interested in finding out more, there is information on our website, or you're more than welcome to contact me or Dr. Deb or Amanda. We'll tell you all about it. And I know there are people from all over North America, all over the world actually, who are watching us. And so I want you to know that there are so many easy ways for you to donate to CSL Kelowna. You can send us a check, you can pay by credit card, you can pay by PayPal, you can send us an indirect e-transfer. Again, all the details are on our website. And we so appreciate all of your support as we awaken humanity to its spiritual magnificence and create a world that works for everyone. And so if you're willing, just take a moment with me and repeat this affirmation if you so choose. I know that my giving blesses and multiplies
all that I am,
all that I have,
and all that I give and
receive. Together, let's say, I do give eternal thanks for the abundance that is mine to share. And now one more time, back to Reverend Christy.
It's been such a pleasure to be with you all this morning. Thank you so much for having me. And as we do all this work to release and to embrace and to shine, what we're really doing is choosing to live from the consciousness of our hearts and to stand in love. So thank you for standing with me. There's a place we can go to, whatever race or creed, a place we can go to, together you and me, a place we can go to stand in unity, hand in hand together, for all the world to see. And that place is love, that place is love, that place is love, and the consciousness of our hearts stand in love. Now is the time we have to make a choice, to go to fear and hatred, or to give love a voice. Now is the time to stand in our belief and to hold in our minds what we want to see. So I stand in love, I stand in love, I stand in love, the consciousness of my heart, I stand in love. Revolution has begun. So I stand in love, I stand in love, I stand in love, in the consciousness of my heart, stand in love. we stand in love. I love you. Namaste.